different issues in this bill, and it may not be possible to cover all of them in such a short program. But let me begin by just talking about some of the naming issues. So, the caregiver is also named in this bill,
mm-hmm.
because we have always realized that it is the families and the caregivers who bear the burden of
absolutely.
Looking after the mentally ill person.
Absolutely.
And they have been given their importance and due place.
Mm-hmm.
There is also a chapter on what is known as an advance directive,
mm-hmm.
which has received a lot of attention in the press.
Mm-hmm.
A person, when of sound mind, or when in good health, can make a deposition and can make an advance kind of a instruction as to what should happen should he or she be a victim of mental illness, who will look after them, which is what is a nominated representative is called, and what are the kind of treatments that they would like. However, advance directives can be superseded in situations where the person's own life is at risk,
okay.
or the lives of other persons or property is at risk.
Mm-hmm.
So advance directive and nominatory representatives are the another departure from the past.
Mm-hmm.
There is a big chapter on the rights of persons with mental illness, which
right.
I think we should talk about.
Absolutely, ma'am.
Apart from that, it has become the duty of the central government to provide mental health care in the least restrictive environment possible,
mm-hmm.
as near to the living situation of the person with mental illness as possible. As far as treatments are concerned, the important issue is that suicide now is no longer to be recognized as a criminal act, rather it is recognized as a person with stress becoming disillusioned with life,
right.
Becoming impossible for them to actually undergo all the stresses that life is giving them.
Right.
And it is to be recognized by the police all over the country that anybody who attempts suicide is likely to suffer from stress,